Well, thanks for clicking on the video. Today I'm back in the woods, I'm with my dog, and today I'm going to be tidying up this woodland camp. That lean-to shelter is not looking too good. I've got a big tarp I want to put over it, and I've got some food that I would like to cook up as well. That's the plan, but let's see what happens. So now that I've got the fire going, the next thing I want to do before I start repairing the shelter is start cooking some food. And for that, I need some hazel. And if this video can get 1,000 likes, I'll come back for a 24-hour camp out. So make sure you hit the like button. And while you're there, you might as well make sure you're subscribed. So while that chicken's cooking, it's now time to repair the shelter. And what do I mean by that? Well, what I want to do is remove all of these dried, dead branches, twigs, and leaves. What I then want to do is, using this tarp that I've brought with me, this is an old tarp, I then want to cover the whole thing with the tarp before adding more fresh green leaves, branches, and sticks to it. Where am I going to get these green sticks and so on? Well, they're doing a lot of forestry here in this woodland, and here we are, perfect example. These are all offcuts. They're not going to be used for anything at all apart from going on the back of the shelter. And if you're wondering about that seasoning mix that I put on the chicken, that's just shop-bought jerk chicken seasoning. So there's quite a few of those ribs, whatever you call them. They're either broken or they're rotten. Ones that are broken or rotten, I'll be replacing. As you can see, I'm making some small improvements, slowly, but I'm getting there. So just a little update. Oh, by the way, it's quite windy today, and I'm sorry if there's a bit of wind noise on the microphone. However, I've replaced quite a few of these rotten ones. I've put in some of these cross beams. I've put in this support there and a few other supports. And now it's time to put the tarp on. Well, this tarp isn't exactly brand new. I didn't buy it from the shop. In fact, I found it in the woodland. And I just thought this tarp is going to be perfect for improving my lean-to shelter. There's a few holes in it, nothing bigger than this. Maybe, I don't know, what's maybe 7 or 8 holes, but nothing too bad. And in fact, when I do sleep under here, when it rains, it's going to be a lot drier than it would have been without this tarp, because this tarp's going to divert a lot of that rain away from me and onto the ground. So now I just need to secure the tarp. I'm not sure, I might use some string, but I'm going to pin it down, and then I'm going to add some more of those cedar boughs to it. So what I'm doing here is I'm just adding weight to the bottom of the tarp, because usually the wind comes from that direction, and if one day it comes from the other direction, it means it won't pick up the tarp and send the tarp flying. That's good chicken. So as you just saw, I've been snapping the ends and then throwing them over. Now what I'm now planning on doing is weaving them in so that they become nice and secure and they won't be going anywhere. It's like a giant version of basket weaving. So now that I've reached the end, I'm now going to start weaving backwards this way. The thing about building one of these shelters is, because it's a natural shelter, nature will take its course and it will dislodge some of the branches, some of the leaves. And with any debris shelter, it's constant maintenance. Every time you go back to your camp, you wanna put another layer on. And as you can see here, they've been doing lots of clearing, and that whole pile there is full of branches, cedar boughs and so on. So I think I might call it a day, and the next time I come back, I'm gonna add just as many branches again, because it really is important to constantly add branches and leaves as well. But I'm quite happy with that. It's been good progress today. And again, I just found a tarp in the woods and I thought I'll just make use of it. I didn't know the measurements of the shelter and it just about fits, which was very lucky. And the most important thing, which is the reason why I did it, why I improved the shelter, was because of the rain. Now when it rains, the rain's gonna just drip off, slide off, it's gonna go the other way, it's not gonna fall down on me and my dog when I'm sleeping. And another great thing is that when the wind blows through, it'll be nice and warm there. Well, that is it for today's video. Thank you very much for watching. And if you haven't already, please hit the subscribe button. And as you know, I'll be back soon. I don't know when, but it'll definitely be another irregular upload. Goodbye. Come on.